Hello, my name is Ed. And if you're listening to this testimony, it's because you're looking for something. And I was looking for something once myself. When I was young, a man told my dad, he said, "You're going to be very proud of that boy someday." My dad said, "I already am proud of him." But that always stuck in my head, and I wanted to make my dad very proud of me, as well as everyone. I wanted everyone to be proud of me. And I graduated high school, I went into the Air Force, and I started drinking, and I started drinking a lot, and I started getting in trouble. I wasn't going to work. Eventually, I got a DUI, I got an Article 15, I was discharged from the military. When I got out of the military, I got my life together, and I was walking with the Lord, and I was faithfully walking with the Lord, and He was really blessing my life. And I was seeking Him because I wanted the light that I heard about many of the pastors speak of, the light that the Bible speaks of, the light that God gives, that gives you enlightenment to the truth. And I found it. And I was enlightened, and my life was very blessed. But then I started turning back to my drinking. And all my blessings fell away, and my life started falling apart. And I had a wife I was married to, a wonderful wife, 13 years, and she left me. And so I cried out to God, said, "God, put me back together again." And He started putting me back together again as I started following Him. And I was an electrician, and I still had this great need to be looked highly upon. And so I really poured myself into my work, and I studied hard, and I gained lots of knowledge, and I rose up in my field of the construction field, in the electrical field. And everybody noticed me for the knowledge that I had, because I had studied so hard. But the knowledge wasn't enough. I wanted glory. I wanted people to give me praises. And so I put all my knowledge to work, and I became one of the best in the county at what I did. And everywhere I went, I received praises for the wonderful hard work that I did. But every time I rose to the top, I would always go back to my drinking. And every time I went back to my drinking, my life started falling apart and falling apart and falling apart. And eventually, I wound up in prison for burglary. And in prison, there, I sought after the Lord again, crying out to the Lord, "Lord, reestablish me. Set my feet back on solid rock. Make me the man that you want me to be. I can't do it myself. I keep trying and I keep failing every time I turn away from you, Lord. What is it with me why I can't do it?" And He revealed it to me, that I can't do it. No man can do it. Only He can do it. And so I opened up my heart again and gave myself to the Lord again. And the Lord is a God of second chances. And in prison, it's a bad place to be. But God can bring good out of bad. He can bring good out of any bad things. For all things work for the good for those who love the Lord. And so I studied, and I studied, and I prayed, and I prayed, and I was discipled under the chaplain and the bishop. And my life started coming together, and I started seeing the light. I started gaining the knowledge, and I started seeing the glory. And it reminds me of the stories in the Bible. It was like the Jews. They always sought for light. They was always after light. And the Romans, they were after glory. And the Greeks, they wanted the knowledge, well known for their knowledge. And that's what I chased all my life. The light, the knowledge, and the glory. But we find in 2 Corinthians 4:6, For it was God who said, let light shine out of the darkness, who has shown in our hearts to bring us the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. There was the light, the knowledge, and the glory, always there in the face of Jesus Christ. And I've seen it there so many times. But because I am who I am, a human being, not a bad person, prison is filled with good people, and good people make bad decisions. But we as human beings, with our own power, will always make bad decisions. That's why we must turn our lives over to Jesus Christ and invite Him into our lives. Let Him take